If you're new to 360 cameras, editing and reframing your 360 videos might feel overwhelming, but it doesn't have to be. In this video, I'll show you how to simplify the entire process and create stunning shots like these in just minutes using the free Insta360 Studio software. You'll learn how to reframe your clips, edit multiple shots together, add music, transitions, and more, all without ever leaving the software. Big thanks to Insta360 for sponsoring this video, and all shots that I'll be editing in the video were shot with the Insta360 X4, which I'll link down below. So step one is to download the Insta360 Studio software from the Insta360 website, which you can find under Downloads, and then simply click to download to either Mac or Windows. Once you've downloaded and installed it, open it up, and this is what it will look like. We're going to start by importing our shots. So with your SD card in your computer, you want to click this plus button and then locate your files and select the ones that you want to import. I'm going to import these ones here. Now I'll click Open. So now on the left-hand side of Insta360 Studio, this is where you'll find all of your shots. You'll see up the top there is an SD card icon. This refers to files that are still on the SD card. There are local files for any shots that might be on your computer that you want to import. There's cloud files for Insta360 Plus, which is their new cloud service, as well as favorites. Now I want to quickly take you through the interface because it is super simple to use. It starts with the interactive viewer here in the middle where you can click to drag and reframe your shots. If you ever want to see an equirectangular view, just click this icon here, which means the full 360 view in a 2:1 aspect ratio, which you probably won't ever want to do, so don't worry about that. On the right hand side, you'll find a few options that have to do with the stitching and processing of your shots, including stabilization that is turned on by default. Then there's stitching, which again, you shouldn't need to touch unless you've been using lens guards, a dive case, or a thermo grip cover with your Insta360 camera. Otherwise, you shouldn't need this menu unless you are encountering any major stitching issues, which I'm not here in my shots. Underneath that is media processing, and here you'll find a bunch of things to do with color and clarity, most of which I wouldn't use since the shots already look quite good straight out of the camera. And if you do want to color correct, I'd recommend doing it in whichever video editor you're planning on using, assuming you're not editing fully in Insta360 Studio. If you are, feel free to play with the basics of these if you want better colors or contrast and so on. Underneath that, you can add a logo to the bottom of your 360 videos if you want to do that. Then there's clip management if you want to create multiple versions of the same shot. And underneath that is file properties, where you can see all the info about the shot you're looking at. Now here at the bottom of Insta360 Studio, you'll find the timeline, which corresponds to whichever shot you've got up in the viewer. If you press spacebar, it will play your shot. You can zoom in and out of the timeline by clicking and dragging this magnifying glass here on the right. Then finally, you can change the aspect ratio of your shots by clicking this icon here and changing to whichever other aspect ratio you want to use. I'd recommend 16:9 for YouTube, 9:16 for TikTok and Instagram Reels, and 1:1 if you want a square. So I'm going to keep this one at 16:9. Underneath that, you'll find screenshot and enter full screen. So the first stage of reframing your 360 videos is going to be choosing the shots that you want to use and then trimming the top and tail off them so you're only left with the best bits. So to look at your other shots, just double click one of them on the left here and they will pop up in the viewer, and then go ahead and watch it back to see if it was a good take. Yep, this one's looking pretty good. I'm just zooming in and out with my mouse here, and that's looking like a really good shot. So I'm going to hit the favorite button on that one so I can tell myself later that that is the good take. And now I'll go through my other clips and favorite the best ones. So to remove the top and tail of a clip, which refers to the empty space at the start and end of your clip where you're still setting up your camera, what I'm going to do is play the timeline forward to the point that I know I want the clip to start, which is about here. I'm going to click this button here, markers trim start. As you can see, that moved the start point from here to here. And likewise at the end, I'm going to go to roughly the end point that I want this shot to end, just before I retrieve my camera. Now I'll click mark as trim end. And you want to also go ahead and do that to the rest of your shots. So now to reframe your 360 videos, what you're essentially doing is choosing static viewpoints that you either want to hold on or transition between throughout the clip. And there are a couple of ways of doing this. The first way is clicking auto frame here. You'll see the face icon with the arrows on it. If you click that, the software is going to do its best to reframe this shot in a way that it thinks is interesting and focuses on the best parts. When it's done processing, it will come up with this carousel down the bottom where you can preview its choices. And look at that. That is really not great, is it? That's not bad, but I think I can do a way better job myself. So I can't recommend using auto reframe at this point in time, which means we're going to reframe these shots ourselves. Before you get started, I'd recommend heading up to Window, then Guides and Enable. This will enable a set of guides that act kind of like a crosshair that helps you keep your shots symmetrical. Because when you're reframing, you don't always know exactly where the center point is, but with these guides, it makes it a lot clearer. So there are a few different grids here you can choose from. I recommend grid lines and crosshair. Now my favorite way of reframing 360 videos is manually adding keyframes. And to do that, make sure the playhead is positioned right at the start of your clip. And what you're gonna do is click your mouse to drag the perspective around and also using the zoom wheel to zoom in and out. So I already know the effect I want. It's gonna be something like this that looks super cool. And what I'm going to do to lock that perspective in place is click this button here, add keyframe. As you can see, this has now added a keyframe to our timeline where it's locked in place these specific parameters as the first viewpoint of this clip. Now I'm going to play the clip forward and I can see I've rotated slightly. So what I'm going to do is play it back and then move to the point that I want to change it, which is here. And I'm simply going to drag the viewer until it looks good. Yep, I like that. And now I'll place another keyframe. So now when I watch that back, there we go. Now I'm going to continue this. So as I play it forward, I'm going to keep myself in the center, adding keyframes as I go. Anytime I leave the center, I'm going to change it and add a keyframe. So what I've done here is kept the same perspective for the first few seconds of this video. Now we're going to get a bit fancy and change the perspective to something else mid-shot. To do that, play the clip forward to the point that you want to place the next keyframe. And again, reframe the shot by dragging with your mouse and zooming in. Then placing another keyframe. I'll play that back. And there we go. We've just changed perspectives. If you do want to hold on a perspective for a few seconds, like here, just click the keyframe button again. So these two keyframes on the timeline are the exact same thing. Then for the next keyframe, you can either keep it the same or change it again. So what I'm going to do is now switch it back to my face, but a super uncomfortable close-up of my face. Anyway, I'm going to add a keyframe here and let's watch this transition. That was a faster one. Nice. One more. I'm going to zoom right out to my first perspective, add a keyframe, and we have just keyframed this shot to be really interesting and engaging by utilizing the full 360 video from this first unique perspective of the tunnel to the close-up shot of the flowers, and then back to that uncomfortably close shot of me that then zooms out back into the tunnel. So I think I want to end my shot about here. So I'll just place one final keyframe with the perspective I want. And now I'm going to move the end here across to the left-hand side. So the clip officially ends there. The next really basic way of reframing your shot is using direction lock. This can be found in the right-hand menu here under stabilization. If you toggle that on, now I'm going to choose my first perspective and add a keyframe. Now what direction lock's going to do is keep this perspective locked on me even as I'm moving in all directions. As you can see, I'm walking around this circular railing, but direction lock is keeping me perfectly centered. Whereas if I had this switched off, that one fixed keyframe that I made is going to stay locked forward on the first direction that I set. So as I play it forward, it's going to stay more on the tree. So I'd recommend using direction lock in situations where you are holding the camera in front of you and you just want it to face one direction only, maybe to show someone's point of view, or you have a fixed perspective from a car or some other kind of vehicle that you don't want to move around. That's when direction lock is going to be the best choice. Another great way to track a subject is with deep track. So if you select this icon here above the timeline and then choose choose your subject, which here is me, then click start tracking, it's going to track me throughout this entire clip. And once it's done, it keeps me in the dead center, even when I'm moving around in all directions. Now you can change the field of view on this track. As you can see, there's a green bar here on the timeline representing the tracking. So if you click that and head up to these options here, you can change a few things like the fisheye and the level of zoom. So find whatever works best for you. So those are all the different ways of reframing your 360 videos. Again, the one I would use in 95% of situations is going to be manual. Adding keyframes, just so you can get that really fine control over every last second of your clip and get it exactly right without relying too much on the software making the creative decisions for you. Next, we're going to play with speed. So I've got a shot here of me walking in a straight line towards this Christmas tree. The whole clip goes for 34 seconds, but what I'm thinking is I'm gonna speed this right up and add motion blur to create this epic fly-in effect. So to do that, head to the very first frame of your video. Then over here on the right-hand side, you'll find time shift. If you click that, now it will allow you to choose the section of your video that you want to change the speed of. So I want the entire thing to be sped up. Now you can choose the speed that it does it. So I'm going to choose 8 times. By default, it's going to turn motion blur on here on the right hand side. Let's watch that back. And great. Keep in mind that previews within the software aren't going to be as high quality as after you export them later. So I do like this shot here, but I think it could be even better with a tilt up at the end towards the top of the tree. So what I'm going to do is go back and keyframe this shot at the start. This is the perspective I want. So I'm going to lock that in. Halfway through, it's still roughly where it needs to be. So I'm going to make another keyframe. Now at the very end of this clip, this is when I need to tilt right up to about there, and I'm going to place a third keyframe. Now let's watch this back. So that was pretty good, but there was that noticeable tilt up halfway through. And the way we can smooth that out is with transitions. To add a transition, head down here to the timeline and click the point between the two keyframes that you want to smooth out. Up will come a bunch of transition presets for us to choose from. Try a few of them out and see which one suits your shot best. I've found that fade in slip out seems to be the one that suits this shot best. Let's take a look. And yes. Now, if you ever want to change a keyframe because you don't like one perspective of the entire video you made, it's very easy to do. Just click on the keyframe on the timeline that you want to change, which will automatically move the playhead directly above it. And now we can just reframe to our heart's content. So this time I want this to be more zoomed in like that. And that has automatically been saved. So when I play that back, it applies the zoom. If you feel like you've totally messed up your reframing and you want to start fresh, just head up to edit, then clear all. So that's deleted the keyframes. Then if I hit edit, clear speed settings, that has now removed the fast motion. So we could go ahead and reframe this shot from scratch if we wanted. I do want to touch on slow motion as well. So I've shot a slow-mo shot here of a water fountain. And it's important with slow-mo shots that you actually shoot in slow motion to begin with your camera. The settings I recommend with the Insta360 X4 is 4K 100 FPS, which is what I use for this fountain shot. And that turned out super well. And as you can see down the bottom, the slow motion has automatically been applied in Insta360 Studio. So for slow motion, there's no extra editing you need to do. Everything would be the same, so you can cut off the top and tail, add your keyframes, and you are good to go. Now, so far we've been editing these shots one by one. And if you're planning on editing in a separate editor like CapCut, DaVinci Resolve, or Premiere Pro, this is the point where you would export your shots to edit in those programs, which I'll show you in a second. But before that, there's one feature I want to show you of Insta360 Studio, which will allow us to edit multiple clips together. So there's really no need to go to another editor if you don't want to. To do that, head up to Project at the top and click it, then create a new project. Choose your aspect ratio and frame rate. If you leave it on auto match, it will automatically detect the frame rate. So that's what I'm going to do, and then go ahead and click confirm. So now in this new window of Insta360 Studio, this is where we can edit our multiple clips together. And it's as simple as drag and drop. And you'll see down here that it's recognized all the keyframes that we set on the previous page. Then you can go ahead and add as many of these clips to the timeline as you like. like. Now you can also repeat the exact same process we went through on the other page here. So if you haven't yet reframed some shots, you can click and drag the perspective in the player, add a keyframe here, and repeat the same process as before. Now here on the project page, there are some options for adding basic extras such as music. They've got an inbuilt library here, or you can import your own if you prefer. Here I've got a track from Epidemic Sound that I dragged and dropped, which you can also edit and trim by just dragging the sides and moving that along the timeline. There's a few text presets here. If you want to add some basic text to your video, just click the yellow plus button to add it to the timeline, where it will show up here on this text layer, and you can edit the text here on the right hand side. Finally, there's some transition presets that you can drag and drop onto the timeline for transition effects in between your various clips for a more stylish transition effect from shot to shot. So you could hypothetically edit an entire video right here inside Insta360 Studio. Look, it's not super advanced, so only do this for the most basic projects where you need a simple cut of a few basic clips with a music track added over the top and some basic titles. If you need anything more than that, I'd recommend editing externally in another editor such as CapCut. Now, when you're happy with your reframing, whether you've done it here in the project menu with multiple clips, or in the media tab where you've reframed your shots individually and want to export them, you can export either one shot by clicking it here on the left hand side, or multiple by holding down shift on your keyboard to select multiple and heading up to the top right hand corner and clicking export. Here you want to export as a video, choose your file path, the aspect ratio should automatically be detected, choose your resolution. If the one you prefer isn't here, you can just type it in. So I want 3840 by 2160, which is 4K. I'm going to choose a recommended bitrate for good quality. I'd recommend the encoding format as H.265 for a mixture of quality and low file sizes. There's no need to tick any of these other boxes aside from flow state stabilization. And when you're done, go ahead and click export. You can find your exports in progress here in the task center, where it will take a few minutes to export each of your shots. So that is Insta360 Studio in a nutshell for 2025. It's a very good and very capable editor, especially for reframing. It's not perfect by any means, but it is a great place to start for quick and easy reframing. So now you've seen how to edit and reframe amazing 360 videos in Insta360 Studio, imagine what you could do if you mastered the entire 360 video workflow. Filming, editing, creating amazing viral shots, and even making passive income with your 360 footage. Well, that's exactly why I made 360 Video 101, my step-by-step course designed to take you from beginner to confident 360 creator. In the course, I'll show you how to get the most out of your Insta360 camera, create professional quality videos, and even monetize your 360 content if that's your goal. And because you're here watching this video, you've proven that you're serious about leveling up your 360 videos. So if you want to fast track your learning and save yourself countless hours of trial and error, you can get your copy of 360 Video 101 down below. And now that you know the basics of using Insta360 Studio, next you'll need to learn how to keyframe your shots in a cinematic way. In this video here, I'll share 10 cinematic movements that you need to try to create amazing looking reframed 360 videos.